What problems do you want? My name's Malin, and I got this idea from Mark Manson, this kind of reframe of discipline and how we see life. And just before I start, I want to say that this video is kind of harsher. It's telling a truth, and truth can sometimes hurt. In today's society, we kind of have this idea that things should feel good. You know, we should follow what feels good and feel satisfaction. And oftentimes that just leads us to following the herd, following the new trends, you know, follow this politics kind of thing and like, oh, this is so bad. And, you know, we should really care about these Aboriginal people and we should really follow the Olympics. And we get caught in this social media and, you know, even in food, you know, like we tend to follow like all these good feeling foods that kind of give us this pleasure that, you know, are famous and that everybody knows. You know, but too much ease and too much pleasure, you know, can kind of lead to this kind of addictive behavior and kind of reliance on it. And, you know, if we grow up in this kind of way, then we believe that things should be easy, that things should be pleasurable. And we get no appreciation of what hard work does, of what reality does, and the satisfaction we can get from dealing with reality, with dealing with these hard problems and working on ourselves. Like things such as working out and building muscle, of eating healthy and having the satisfaction of cooking good, clean, healthy, whole foods, and having good sleep, you know, going to bed early and waking up early and having the satisfaction of that. You know, and oftentimes these things are long-term investments. You know, they cost something in the short term and often that's quite painful, but in the long term they have a return and they have an investment. You know, it's delaying gratification. There's this marshmallow test with the kids, you know, where they're given, they said, you can have one marshmallow now or you can have two later. And the study actually found that a lot of kids weren't willing to wait. And it'd be very interesting to see what it would be like now, because I doubt that many kids at all would wait for the second marshmallow. And even though it makes sense, like, oh, I get two more if I just have to wait these couple minutes. Oftentimes we can't do that. And if people aren't willing to pay that price, then they're not willing to wait for something to get something. They're not willing to pay a price to get a bigger reward. And this just leads to people kind of seeking these quick, easy kind of pleasures. And, you know, in our society especially, this is very insidious. This is very dangerous because we have too much pleasure. We have too many opportunities to have a very easy life. You know, we could get food delivered to our door. We could stay indoors all day just playing video games, watching movies. If we feel in love, you know, we can just open up Pornhub. We could just masturbate and whatever and get our needs met just in our home, just in our little room, in our own kind of circle. And this may seem quite drastic when I say it, but like this is a very sad and desperate way to live. And I think an important problem to ask is not what pleasure do you want, not what do you want out of life, because then you're looking for what feels good, you're looking for what feels nice, like, oh, if it doesn't feel good to work out, then I'm not going to work out. Of course, working out has some sort of pain and some sort of difficulty to it, but that's what makes it so much more satisfying, because you pay a price to get a reward in the future. And so this problem, this question, what problems do you want, is really a reframe. It's not pleasure, it's not purpose, because all these things have a cost. They all have a hidden cost behind them. You know, you don't just get purpose from nothing. You don't just feel great about life and then go and change the world. It costs something. It costs something to build up your body. It costs something to build up a business. And for an example, I just want to talk about me and my relationship with food. You know, I've talked about this a bit in my binge eating kind of video, but it was only recently that I realized, you know, I kind of just took a look and I was like, I've really been a slave to food. You know, I've been chasing this kind of next hit. I've been relying on it to ease my pain, you know, and I've been very dependent on it. And, you know, in the back of my mind, it's like, oh, this is okay, you know, I'm not eating too bad, I'm eating rather healthy, I'm just eating along and, you know, I'm just trying to get through my life, whatever. But like, all of a sudden you just look around and it's like, oh, like this is actually bad. You know, I've just been on another binge and this is not what I want in my life. This is not very healthy. And you just kind of wake up all of a sudden in it, and you're just in this haze and you're just like looking around and you're surrounded by rappers. You're surrounded by this just feeling of guilt. You're just like, I feel absolutely terrible. You know, I just had a sugar high and then all of a sudden it's crashed, you know, because my insulin spiked. And then all of a sudden I've just crashed. And then when it crashes, you get this adrenaline kind of shot to try and get you to want more. But then this also creates anxiety and can cause a lot of mental health issues because you're just living like this. And the actual scary thing is that people get used to living like that and they think that it's normal, and our bodies adapt and get used to these kind of things. And rather than seeing that life can be kind of lived at this nice, satisfying level, we're kind of like this ups and downs and ups and downs and up highs and lows and just this emotional turbulence, you know. We feel great and everything's going great, and then all of a sudden we crash and we come down and it's the end of the world and we feel absolutely fucking depressed. And you know, this the scary thing is that one cookie never means one cookie, you know. It's like we kind of tell ourselves, oh, it'd be okay if I just had a cookie today. You know, I've been eating healthy, kind of not feeling great, and you know, I kind of deserve a cookie today, so I'm gonna eat it. And it seems so nice. It seems like, oh, this is just harmless. But then one cookie turns into another, turns into you coming home and looking for that next hit, looking for those, whatever ultra processed food you like. And these foods are addictive. Like literally scientists create and work on creating the best formula for the cheapest price. And I mean, that's like a whole other story. Like just realize that people are creating these things to be addictive, and they aren't going to change it because they're earning billions of dollars from this stuff. They're earning billions and billions of dollars. So why would they change, you know? And for me, I just realized, I don't want to live like this. I don't want to live for food. I don't want to live chasing this next high. I don't want to live not knowing the potential of my body. And I'm lucky because I've had a taste of freedom. I've had the taste of what it's like to be healthy, of to chase your goals and to build up my skills, you know, in soccer and in working out. These things have taught me quite a lot. And even in music, just realizing that if I put effort and time into this thing, then it can grow and I can become better. And when you're healthy, these things are nice. You don't want these quick hits of dopamine. You actually are happy to pay the price, so then you get this benefit because that's more satisfying to you than it. And it's not this great, oh, it feels amazing, you know. It's not like this sugar high. It's like this feeling of satisfaction, like I did some good shit today and I'm going to sleep feeling tired, but that feels amazing. You know, my muscles are sore from the workout. I'm feeling tired from working out at soccer. I'm feeling a bit frustrated because I wrote a song and it was really great, but then I want to make another one and I just want to refine it and make it better. And these things to me are so much more beautiful, and they're not this big amazing thing. It's like reality. It's just like this nice contentment and satisfaction with my life. And so I want to ask you, like, what are you willing to suffer for? You know, there's a pain for every choice that you have, and you have to choose, you know. Do you want to pay the price now to have a better future, or do you want to just keep going as you're going? And I mean, that's just your choice. If you're fine eating these foods and you don't mind, you just want to enjoy food, fine, that's up to you. But for me, my choice was that I don't want to be a slave to food. I don't want to know what it's like. I don't want to live my life and look back and say, oh, I was always waiting for some day to be healthy. I was always waiting for some day to go all out in my workouts, to build the physique that I wanted. I was always waiting for one day to start a business. I was always waiting one day to do these things that I want to do. And I realized that if I don't make a decision, if I don't start making action towards it now, then it's never going to happen, because now is all that we have. So what problems do you want to have? Do you want to work a 9-to-5 job? Do you want to live based on sugar cravings and the instability that it brings on your emotional and hunger-driven life? And are you willing to pay the price? Because it is going to hurt, and that's the cost of it. We like to want the good. We want to look good. We want to feel good, and we want to have the great body. We want to have the perfect body, but we aren't willing to pay the price that it costs to have that body. And you have to be aware that everything has a cost. You know, even eating pleasurable foods, you know, these things have a cost. More sickness, emotional instability, yada yada. You can kind of research this yourself if you want to. But we have to choose now, because someday is as good as never. So thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.